sorry, babe. I'm an ambitious girl. You're just small time.
City is in shock today as the police and emergency services deal with the aftermath of a devastating attack on a police convoy this morning. As yet, no details have been released about the prisoners being transferred in the convoy, and no group has claimed responsibility. The convoy left police headquarters early this morning for a routine transfer of felons to Liberty Penitentiary. The attack took place on the Callahan Bridge, leaving few witnesses and the bridge itself severely damaged. Some of the convicts are thought to have perished in the explosion that followed the initial attack. Revelations as to the professionalism of the attack struck police hours afterward, when identification of the missing felons were further hampered by an attack by computer hackers on police headquarters databases. With the Porter Tunnel project falling behind schedule, this disaster leaves Portland isolated from the rest of the city.
Come on! Señor Dickhead! It's no problem to kill you. You're gonna be sorry. Aye, aye, get lost.
I know a place on the edge of the red light district where we can lay low, but my hands are all messed up, so you better drive, brother. This is the place right here. Let's get off the street and find a change of clothes. I know this guy. He's connected. His name's Luigi. Me and him go back, so I could probably get you some work. Come on, let's head over there. Around the back and use the service door.
Wait here, man, while I go in and talk to Luigi.
Paintball's got some business upstairs. Well, maybe you could do me a favor. One of my girls needs a ride, so grab a car and pick up Misty from the clinic, then bring her back here. Remember, no one messes with my girls. So keep your hands on the wheel. If you don't mess this up, maybe there'll be more work for you. Now get out of here.
Luigi said, to give you this, so here, take it.
There's a new high on the street. Goes by the name of Spank. Some wise guy's been introducing this trash to my girls down Portland Harbor. Go and introduce a bat to his face. Then take his car, respray it. I want compensation for this insult!
Thank you.
on a combo. What am I gonna do? Wait. Hey, I gotta talk to you. All right, Mick, I'll talk to you later. How you doing, kid? The Don's son, Joey Leone. He wants some action from his regular girl, Misty. Go pick her up at Hepburn Heights, but watch yourself. That's Diablo turf. Then run her over to his garage in Trenton and make it quick. Joey ain't the kind you keep waiting. Remember, this is your foot in the door. So keep your eyes on the road and off Misty.
I'll be with you in a minute, spark plug. Hey, I'm Joey. Luigi said you were reliable, so come back later. There might be some work for you. All right?
Player hater.
You ain't no gentleman.
It's remarkable, I think. Think of all the things you do. I mean, who do you want to buy in this city? What do you
do? I go to a shop, and the name's Laszlo.
I show Leslie. I'm a bank provisioner. Well, I don't. I buy it online, and then I just need to get the business for that. But while I'm done, it's incredible. I also have a cooking and galaxy. The internet is really good for my house. It's amazing. I can do that a lot, but I don't have to go out ever again. It's incredible. I don't envy this business. Stop. They earn them, and that has changed my life.
This is really going nowhere.
It's no trouble for you.
No, it's you again. Older and everything, but yeah, he treated me really good.
Some Diablo scumbag has been pimping his scuzzy bitches in my backyard. Go and take care of things for me. If you need a piece, go around back of Avenue Nation opposite the subway.
You said you'd need a piece, so go around the back of the shop. I left you a 9 in the yard.
Ball is being held at the old school hall near the Callahan Bridge, and they'll be looking for some old school action. Now, I got girls all over town walking the street. Get them to the ball. They'll make a bundle. Get as many of them as you can before the cops drink away their grain.
Thank you. time to go.
Okay, did you have anything relevant to say?
Yeah, dude, that B dude.
Chunky Lee Chung is pushing Spank for some new gang from Colombia or Colorado or something. I'm not really sure. Who needs details? Anyway, he's got a noodle stand down in Chinatown. That rat has sold his last stir fry. I want you to take him out. If you need a piece, go around back of ammunition opposite the subway. Sort yourself with a nine. You know where it is, right? Well, remember, just watch your back in Chinatown. It's Triad territory.
Stop! Where's my damn tool?
Move it! Stop or I'll shoot!
Put it down!
Where's my damn tool?
Get that guy!
Okay.
This is the police! Stop!
You are risking your life! Get that guy!
Northwest Bend.
Oh, thank
God! Oh, no,
no, no,
baby!
Kiss your ass goodbye.
Idea of combining martial arts and organic food. I mean, it's kind of like putting ice cream on pizza. Both are great, but they really shouldn't be put together.
Okay, Vasco, actually, it is nothing like ice cream and pizza. Ice cream is milk-based, as we all know, and I am lactose intolerant, and pizza...
All right, we're gonna hit the payroll van. It leaves the edge of Chinatown every day. Bullets won't even dent the van's armor, so get a car and ram it off the road. Now hit it hard, and the punk-ass security guard should bail. Then take it to the warehouse at the docks, and my guys are gonna take over from there. Now it won't be doing its rounds all day, so don't hang around.
The inside cover of your book that you still live in your parents' basement.
Okay, if... Chapter 17 of my book, which I know you've read, I address the dangers of cynicism. That though, closed mind is like a closed fist, and karate means open hand. But it might as well mean open mind. If you like wheatgrass, I think you'll believe it.
Well, I'm not a masticating cow, so I really don't enjoy chewing damp hay and prancing around in leggings, shouting,
"My God!"
Okay, Dad, though, I'm warning you this time. Do not make me angry. Mad for my karma. Definitely be bad for your karma. I studied the martial arts so I can stand up fully, just like you. And I encourage everyone listening out there on Chatterbox to buy my book and learn how organic food and martial arts can help.
And I encourage anyone who needs a doorstop or a booster seat to buy it as well. Let's see who's on the phones. Hello, caller. You are on the air.
Hello, Reed. I bought your book.
Thank you.
I want to ask about chapter 29, yoga, not yogurt.
Oh, yeah.
So wonderful. I rejected chocolate milk. legs have been on the couch for 2 days now. But my husband says it looks like an exorcist. I even saw the ferry on the top shelf of the bridge so I couldn't reach it with my legs hanging out of the head now. But I can reach the front of the down. What can I do, Reed?
Do not threaten me, Charlie.
Shut up, you carnivore. Why don't you go gnaw on a bone like you were the bad, though? Our ancestors didn't eat chicken wings.
They lived at one with nature and ecosystem. Such as the diet of berries and beefy vegetables.
Yes, and they threw stones at their own shadow and died of old age and fear at 24.
Glad, though, cold and hard. But let me answer the question. When I'm in trouble or tempted by the all-you-can-eat breakfast food,
get some bacon in here.
Glad, though, I go back to the table. I start the day with a juicy beverage, meditation, 6 hours of yoga. Next, I go open up my job.
Things used to be better.
And who wants a steak after that? Okay, next caller, you are on Chatterbox and Reed Tucker.
Yo, B.
Have no respect for authority.
there is one thing that would whip them into shape.
Let me guess, the military.
That's right. The military teaches you respect, obedience, and gives you a good pension. These kids that thought they were going to be millionaires, look where the information highway has gotten them. Nowhere. It's a dead end. Uncle Sam takes care of his boys and some girls. More people would join the military, this would be a better country. These kids don't respect veterans. We fought for your freedom. When I came back from the Australian-American War, I didn't get a hero's look. I didn't get a pat on the back from my friends and neighbors saying thanks for fighting for our freedom, Jane. After years of fighting in the trenches, I come back here and everyone's watching TV.
Now, can you tell me what this Australian-American War was? I mean, I really never heard of it.
God, not another one. Have you read a history book lately, son? The Australian-American War was the biggest war since the Big War. I tell you, I did two tours to take boomerang shrapnel in my head so I could come back here and have a bunch of hits denied. Yes. Those Aussies are ruthless. They even wired kangaroos with explosives. Come hopping in a kid, knock out 10 guys.
Well, thanks for the history lesson. All right, let's go over here. Hello, caller. You're on Chatterbox.
Yeah? Is that Blasto?
Yes, it is. Who's this?
It's real on
No, not really. I mean, this is a radio show. People usually tell us their name.
My name is real unimportant. If you want to keep being a wise guy, you'll find out just how unimportant. Like, unimportant, I just got shot in the head. Unimportant. Will I make myself clear?
Yes. Why are you calling in today?
Because I need some advice. And I ain't doing any of that shrink shit.
If you swear again, we're gonna have to cut you off. This is a family show.
Sorry. Just a little unhappy. I've been agitated. Real angry. It's my mom. She don't think I'm a real man. Can you imagine that? I mean, I do a man's job and all, but she treats me like a little boy. All I get is, you're pa this and you're pa that and you ain't a real man, Tony, and it's driving me freaking nuts.
Well, Tony...
How'd you know my name was Tony? You're tracing this call? What? If you are, you're gonna get real intimately acquainted with what your brains look like. My name ain't Tony, okay?
Okay.
Not Mom! She keeps going, Tony, Tony, be a real man. Stand up for yourself. Don't take no shit. But all I do is to be a good son. And I want her to show that she cares for me. Show that she loves me. And, you know, say I was a good kid. But it seems like nothing's ever good enough for her. You know what I mean? What do I do?
Well, Tony, I mean, sir.
Seven seas.